in the seascape. And before I do that, I want to mask out the dolphin and mask out some sort of foam and breaking waves sort of shapes in the sea. So just a little tip about masking fluid. When you go to pick your masking fluid bottle up, have a check. If it's all sort of, you know, congealed at the bottom like that, this is the pink masking fluid. A lot of the strength of the masking fluid is in that red colour there. So what I would suggest you do is don't start using it yet. Give the bottle a few minutes, just rocking it back and forth to get all of that strength of the masking fluid back in the main body of the liquid, okay? Don't shake it. If you shake it quite briskly, you'll end up with a lot of froth. So when you dip your brush into that froth then and you brush it onto your painting, it disperses and leaves a very thin and patchy covering, okay, which you may not want. You might want a proper smooth covering. So I'm just going to put this on pause while I rock the bottle back and forth until all of that red rim has gone, okay? Okay, that took about 3 or 4 minutes, just gently rocking the bottle back and forth like that. And now it's all evenly distributed within the bottle, okay? All the strength of the masking fluid is even. So I'm ready to use that now. And another little tip, use a scruffy old cheap brush from, say, a value pound shop or something. Don't use your best watercolour brushes for applying masking fluid, because it does tend to gunk up the hairs and gets up in the sort of hilt of the brush. Even so, you can sort of preserve these brushes by just dipping your brush in water, tap it on the base to get rid of all the air bubbles, and just wipe it in a bit of soap, and then with your fingers just squeegee that excess soap out. And just by doing that, it gives the hairs a bit of protection. So I'm ready now to sort of go into the masking fluid and start applying that. As you can see, because I rocked the bottle back and forth, I haven't got a layer full of froth. I've got a sort of clear area that I can dip into, which is what you want. And start applying the masking fluid now to these sort of patchy, foamy shapes. I'm using cold pressed paper, which will give me a bit more tooth and ability to make a ragged, foamy edge in the sea. I'm applying it quite scruffily, almost dry brushing it across the surface, so I'm getting a broken application of the masking fluid. It's not solid, it's not perfect, it's a bit scruffy, which is fine. I'm not after a perfect coating of masking fluid for this seascape. I might be if I was doing another subject, but for this will do fine. So I'm sort of scampering across the paper with this scruffy brush to get a patchy effect. As you can see, I'm leaving some of the white of the paper even within the area that I'm masking out. I'm doing that because then it'll key in, sort of dovetail in a bit better with the rest of the painting as we progress. Because if you've got a solid block of white, it's going to look a bit strange in water, because water's a moving body and it will have breaks and changes in it. For the dolphin, I'm going to use as broad strokes as I can. Another tip, when you're applying masking fluid, I find that if you apply it all in the same direction as I'm doing now, when you come to peel it off, there's less risk of the paper tearing because it's all pulling off in one direction. And I'm not scrubbing it on, I'm just gliding it on, so that it sits on the surface of the paper rather than going deep into the cotton fibres. and that helps as well sort of reduce the risk of tearing your paper. So it lightly does it. But you still need a fair amount, you know, don't be too skimpy with it. Especially on cold pressed or rough paper, you need to make sure you're covering this area, which this time I actually do want it to be a solid covering with no gaps. So take your time and get a good consistent covering of masking fluid. At the other extreme, if you put it on way too thick, it'll take a very, very long time to dry. And it's a bit harder to rub off then because you've got lumps of it or bulges of it. And they can tend to look dry on the outside, but then when you start to rub them off, you find that they haven't dried thoroughly, and then you've got this moist rubber mess all over your painting. So it's just sort of the middle road applying this. I'm still trying to keep my brush strokes horizontal as I've done over the first part I've masked out. Takes a while doing this, but it'll be worth it in the end, because then when we've masked this dolphin out, we can go mad with the sky and go wet into wet, and we haven't got to worry about cutting around the subject, which is our dolphin. So I'll just put that on pause while I continue. Right, so the dolphin is completely covered, and now I'm just going to have some spatter. So I'm just loading the brush up and holding it about 10-12 inches above the painting. I'm just shaking the brush, letting all these drops fall where they may for a bit of interest. I'll have some going up into the sky as well. I want quite a few around the tail where it might be causing a splash as it leaves the water. Alright, so that's done. And then you want to rinse your brush straight away. Give it a good rinse. Tap it on the base of the jug. And then again, rub it in some soap. And that should, if you squeegee out, can you see the masking? There's a little ring of masking fluid coming off there with my nail. So that's more or less off. And then pull it back into shape and it's ready for use for the next time. I'm going to let that masking fluid dry completely before, it must be bone dry before we start painting on it. So that'll probably be at least 2 hours, and then you can finish it off with a hairdryer. Part two is coming next. At the end of part one, I'd just rinsed out my brush after doing the masking fluid on the dolphin. I'd rinsed my brush out like that, and all the masking fluid residue had gone into the jug. Do not use this water to now carry on with your watercolour painting. Get rid of it and wash the jug out as well, because there'll be masking fluid in the water, suspended in the water. Get a clean jug of fresh water. I'm just preparing to paint the sky area in this dolphin painting. So before I go ahead and start wetting it, I just want to show you the colours that I've mixed up. Because once I've wet it, and it's soaked in for about half a minute, I'll be painting quick wet into wet washes. So the colours I've mixed up are French Ultramarine Blue and some Cadmium Scarlet. Then French Ultramarine Blue, Cadmium Scarlet and some Sap Green. And then lastly, some French Ultramarine Blue and some Burnt Sienna. And all of these are sort of bluey, greeny hues. They've either been deadened with the complement red or, in this case, burnt sienna. So it should give us a nice variety of greens and blues in the sea for interest. The sky itself will be plain French ultramarine blue. And then I'll start adding these colours as I come down. So I've prepared the painting, first of all, by wetting it with clear water. be very generous, because if you're painting on cotton rag paper, it soaks up a lot of moisture and it gives you plenty of time for working wet into wet. Then you haven't got to panic because your paper's drying out. When you think it's wet enough, give it another soak. I'm only going to wet down as far as this last patch of masking fluid, and I'll be doing the last part of the see at the separate sort of video clip. I'm just concentrating on this part of this sea and sky for now. So a lot of water going on. What I'm aiming for is for this layer of water to have soaked in enough in the next minute or so for me to then just put another layer on. And then let that soak in also until it reaches the point where it's a bit satin, there's a sheen on the paper. While there's still a sheen or a shine on the paper, that's great, we can put the washes in. If it goes damp, that's too dry. So I'm just going to see if I can show you by tipping the board. That shine, yeah, it's showing up now. If it's too wet, water will run off as it's doing there, so just tip off the excess. Don't be afraid to move your board around to distribute the water all around your wetted area evenly. Okay, starting to pick up a bit of the shine there. Literally about a minute and a half or so should be enough time for you to for the water to soak in. I'm going to have some tissue paper at the ready because I want to lift out some fairly hard-edged clouds I'm going on. So first of all, I'm going to paint, mix up a puddle of French ultramarine blue for the top half of the sky. I'm just going to take that blue down a little bit by adding a speck of burnt umber, just a little bit on the corner of my brush. I'm just looking at my paper though, and it's still a little bit too wet. If I tilt it, as you can see, there's water running off the corner there, so still too wet for a minute. So tilt your board again and just redistribute that water. Give it a few more seconds, or half a minute, say, to soak in again. And I'm just going to take off the droplets of water that are on the dolphin as well, because when I brush my brush over those, they'll dilute my wash colour, which I may not want, so I'll get rid of those. Right, okay, almost there now. So I'm just going to put on some of this fairly light blue. I'm leaving a ridge there for some clouds. I'm painting more blue, so I'm leaving about an irregular inch or so of white there to suggest the banks of clouds. And I'll take this blue then all the way down. To this initial pink band of masking fluid. So into that I want to start to add this darker wash, which is the French ultramarine blue and some burnt sienna. Just going to bring that across there, just to add a darker area of blue. And that'll flare up into the painting. Then I'm going to go for the French ultramarine blue and cadmium scarlet and add a band of that. And maybe take some down into the near the bottom of the painting. And finally, I'm going for this mix of French ultramarine blue, cadmium scarlet, and some sap green, just to introduce a little bit of green into the mix. And I'm just stroking it across, mingling it in with some of the other colours. I'm going to take some of that up into the sky area a little bit higher. Okay, at this point I just want to tip the board and let everything run. I'm tipping it almost at 90 degrees and letting all those strokes soften a little bit more. And also, with a brush that's been wetted and then wiped, I'm going to lift out some paint that might be sort of catching my eye and in the wrong place. I'm going to press in and get some harder edges. Actually, I'll use a tissue for that as well. Just dry tissue, press into the tops of those white clouds, just for a bit of stronger contrast. And then I want to get an effect of sort of sea mist. So I'm going to get a round brush, wet the round brush. It's full of water and I just want to stroke it across the painting. Repeat if necessary. And then that should start to cause a little bit of a back run either side of the stroke, which will hopefully give a sort of misty effect. I can also spray into it very gently with one of these little bottles and get an effect that way as well. Okay, so at this point I just want to create the feeling of some waves, movement, soft water. Tip the board again and let all of that run. If you get any paint building up at the side, just be there with the tissue and mop it up. And before it dries completely, I'd wipe off all of these paint droplets on the dolphin. For the next stage of the painting, I'm going to try and put in a sort of feeling of a curling wave in this section. The painting is bone dry now, as is the masking fluid. Everything's totally dry. It's had about an hour and a half to dry, something like that. So to just strengthen up some of the sea area as well, I want to add just a few strokes of whatever colours I've got left on my palette. I was using French Ultramarine Blue plus some Cadmium Red. So I'll just strengthen that up. That's a bit too much red, so just add some more blue. Take that back down towards the blue side. And I'm just going to pop in some of that here and there, just to add a little bit of contrast in the sea area. And I'm painting it around some of the masked out pieces so that there'll be contrast when the masking is rubbed away. All I'm trying to create is the sensation of light and dark in the water by using that extra dark bit of painting I just did on top of the paler washes underneath. Then I'm coming along with the brush that's been dipped in water and shaken, and there's just a little bit of moisture left in the hairs. And I'm going to run my brush along that very finely and soften that edge as it blends into the sea as it goes into the distance. And I'm going to soften this edge as well, because these are the distant waves in the sea and I want them to be a bit softer than the ones in the foreground. So rinse my brush again. That's a little bit hard there, so I'll just touch into that, wiggle the brush back and forth and let that bleed up. And some of these maybe are, perhaps I've got a few too many hard edges here, so I'll just soften into the underneath of some of these, just again to have a contrast of hard and soft, light and dark in the water area. Okay, so to put a feeling of a curving wave, I'm going to use a softer, paler wash of the French Ultramarine Blue with the Cadmium Scarlet. So it's much paler than the one I just used there. I'm using a flat brush and I'm just going to drag it leaving some sparkle of the paper showing through. So it's quite patchy. And then I'm just going to add a little bit of that darker mixture right up into the sort of top of the wave, under the masked out white bit where the wave would be a bit darker. So hopefully this will create the feeling of that rolling sensation. Then with flat brush again, I'm going to paint some strokes now as if this wave is coming onto the sand. So a few strokes like that. And as I'm coming forward, more dry brush strokes. A bit more French Ultramarine Blue in. I'm leaving quite a bit of the white paper showing now, to indicate that the water's coming onto the sand, onto the beach. I'm just going to bring this down a little bit further. And maybe add another streak or two. I'm just going to add a tiny little bit of green hue. I mixed earlier some French Ultramarine Blue, some Cadmium Scarlet and a bit of Sap Green. I've got a bit of that still left on the palette. I'm just adding a tiny bit more Sap Green in there. And I'm going to put it again in the top part of the wave where it's darker there. Just to echo the green that's in the sea further away, and I might have a little streak of it in the foreground ripples as well, just for colour harmony. And now I'm going to stop there with the sea piece. One thing that is jumping out at me is that I could make the bases of the rolling wave a bit paler. So I'm going to press in with a dry tissue and make those a bit paler. And maybe soften some of them with a moist brush. So moist brush, just rotate into that area of just patted dry, just to soften it away to nothing. Rinse often and soften in the bottom of the wave there. And let that dry completely. The painting is bone dry now, and before I started rubbing off the mask, I used a bit of slightly damp tissue to wipe away any paint droplets that were left on the masking fluid. Because if you start to rub that off, sometimes the paint, even though it seems dry, it can have a little bit of moisture in there. And as you're rubbing it off, it'll smudge into your white highlight that you've tried to preserve by using the masking fluid. So it's good to get rid of any big sort of passages of paint that are sitting on top of your masking fluid. So I'm just using the side of my thumb to rub the masking fluid off. It's bone dry now. I'm trying to keep my thumb pressed hard to the paper and just work methodically across. I'll just put the camera on pause. If you do pull it like this, try to keep it low to the paper rather than ripping it off high, because if you keep it low, there's less chance of tearing the watercolour surface. Okay, so I'll just pause for now. So I've rubbed off all of the masking fluid and now this is what's left. We've got a perfect shape for the dolphin, which we'll now start to paint, and we've got a lot of hard edges of preserved white in the sea. Some of these are going to need to be softened. I'll leave some of them intact, but to soften some of them, just come along with a mid-tone bluey grey, and I'm using a flat brush here, and what I'm going to do is just work in horizontally, just skim lightly over some of the white highlights, not all of them but some, and that'll take them down a little bit. They won't look so hard edged then, because by just touching over some of them in places, that will relax the pigment that's surrounding their edges. So we have a nice mix of hard and soft edges again. Just take some of them down, even on the crest of the wave here. I'm just using the corner of my brush and just making some little speckles, touching part on the pink that's under the curve of the breaking wave and part on the white of the breaking wave, to key in and make those two marry a bit more softly in places. I'm using some speckles as well to suggest foam, and you can do that in the base of the wave, just some speckles, irregular shapes, irregular sizes, and hopefully all that will start to say wave, preferably breaking wave. Maybe some foamy shapes, some speckles and dots and strange organic shapes in the foreground, in this soft blue-grey. So the next thing to do is to start wetting the dolphin now, so that he's ready to put the washes into. So I'm using a size 3 brush because I want to wet him really accurately, especially around the outline. So getting as close as I can to the edge where the dolphin sits right next to the sky colour. There might be a little bit of bleed from the sky colour coming into the dolphin. That should be alright, because the dolphin will be quite a darkish blue in places anyway. So that won't matter. So take your time and go accurately around the dolphin to wet him. I'll put this on pause while I continue wetting the dolphin. Okay, I've wet the dolphin and he's got a satin sort of sheen on his body now. If you can just see that on camera. It's had a soak and it's had about a minute to go in, and now the surface of the paper has got little sort of dimples all over it. I just want to re-wet a little bit just to make sure I got plenty of working time to put the washes into the body of the dolphin. I'll just zoom in a bit. So another bit of water to keep it all moist as I'm working. But I want some lovely smooth soft lines in his body, especially in the initial stages. If you tilt your head and you look at it and it's starting to look damp, i.e. when there's no shine on there, wet it again, because if it's damp it won't flow well for you. Okay, so the colour I'm going to use to put the first wash in is a bit of French ultramarine blue and a little bit of that grade blue, which was French ultramarine blue, and a little tiny bit of cadmium scarlet. So very soft blue wash, slightly grayed by the cadmium scarlet, and get that in first of all. Just painting it in strokes. Go as close as you can to the outline so that we don't get the white rimmed look of a cut-out dolphin if we can avoid it. It's tricky to do. If you mask something out and you paint a background, let that dry and then start to rub the masking fluid off, you know, you always get a bit of a cut-out look. It's quite hard to avoid. So I will be coming in a sec with a much smaller brush, like a size 0, and going in really as tightly as I can to kill the white rim around the dolphin so that I can avoid that look as much as possible. But for now I want some washes in the body. Define that fin a bit better there. Again, another little thing, one of the downsides of using masking fluid is that it has not destroyed, but it's affected the surface of the paper, and it's a little bit more scratchy than it would have been if I hadn't masked it out. But there we are, you have to sacrifice something to some work in practice, you have to sacrifice something. So I'm using a smaller brush now to go really tight into literally slightly a millimetre over the edge, just to key the background in with the outline of the dolphin. The back doesn't matter so much because that's on a white cloud, that's up against a white cloud anyway. It's just where it's sheer up against the darker sea piece. So I want to get that tight as I can. Okay, so let's go for some darker washes now. I'm just going to stop because this is getting a very long video clip, so I'll carry on in another part. Carrying straight on from where I was in the last video, the dolphin is still moist. I've just put that first wash in. Now I'm going to go for stronger French ultramarine blue with a bit of cadmium scarlet in there, which is its opposite on the colour wheel, which will give us a lovely grade blue, stronger blue. And I want to start building the shape of the dolphin now. Fin in there. I'm going to lift out a nice highlight from the fin in a minute. I'm just going to put the colour on first of all, and then I'll be able to shape it with a thirsty brush by bit. So there's the colour going on. As you can see, it's flaring a little bit. So what you can do is just tip your painting, just zoom out again, and let that all run so that my brush strokes are softened. Things look a little bit more natural. Okay. So the darker part of the fin there. darker passage there, just blending it away. Right under the tail, I'm going to put some really strong shadows in now, so much stronger Felsham Touring Blue, and this time a bit of Burnt Sienna, which is a much stronger addition than the Cadmium Red. And let's get much stronger blue on there, and on the head. And I'm just going to drag those streaks through. On that side of his body. And his tail there would be a bit darker. And again, I'm going to tip that and just let that run. Zoom out. Just let that run again. And then run it back in the other direction and soften all of that. So now we've got, hopefully, the dolphin starting to take shape on the paper. Just zoom in again. And now I want to carve out some highlights to start defining the form a bit better. So to do that, I'm going to really rinse my flat brush. It's a 3/4 inch flat brush. I've taken all the moisture out of it now. And I'm going to lift a highlight there and just drag that across to start defining the sort of there's a bulge there on the head. And the tip of his nose is paler. And then under his belly is paler as well. So I'm going to drag colour out of that. Then there's already a highlight there which I partly left, but I'm going to accentuate that highlight. And a bit lighter in that area there. Then let's have a bit of a highlight there to separate the centre of the tail from the end. Press the edge of the brush in and drag to get back to the white of the paper. I'm trying to make that a bit soft. A little highlight there. Again, when you're lifting highlights, you need to rinse the brush every time and dry every time, otherwise you're just going to put paint back on the painting. Let's have it a bit lighter in this area, just under where his eye will be. Probably getting a lot of reflected light bounce up from the ocean. So again, at that stage, I want to leave it dry. So I'm going to put the film on pause while I just dry it. And then we'll be doing the final wet onto dry markings on the dolphin. At this point now, the painting is bone dry. So we're going to be painting wet onto dry. But before that, now is a good time to rub away any pencil marks that you can see. Not all of them will come off, but some of the graphite will come away. And, you know, every little helps. So I'm just taking away whatever graphite has floated to the surface in the painting process. And it just makes your paintings look a little bit more painterly. Just taking it off. And again, this is on bone dry paper, obviously. So now, to add some final accents on the dolphin. Mixed up a puddle of French ultramarine blue, and cadmium scarlet. Make sure I've got enough because I want to do some darkening here and there, and I don't want to run out halfway and have to mix more. So that's my dark accent colours. You can see it's quite contrasting to the blue that's there. In fact, it's a bit too dark. So I'll just add a brush full of water to that to dilute it down. I'm going to have a softening brush at the ready. So that's a brush that's just been moistened, flicked and laid there waiting. If you dab it into a flannel before you use it, you'll take off too much moisture. So just wet it, flick it and leave it on your palette and it's ready then to go. So I'm just going to get some dark accents in now. This is the core shadow here where the light isn't getting to certain parts of the dolphin. So I'm putting the colour on and straight away with that moist brush I'm going to touch into that edge and soften it all the way. Rinse your brush often, flick it and keep on going, and this will key that dark shadow into the painting underneath. Same again with the underneath line. I'm wetting that just at the edge and going right on the edge of that dark passage I've just painted. Wiggling my brush along, rinse it, it's full of pigment now, and then keep on softening. The hairs of my brush are all making contact with the paper and holding it very flat to the surface. Rinse your brush, flick, keep on going right down. You've got to work quickly because we're painting wet onto dry and we'll get a hard edge if you don't move fast. Okay, so that's how it's looking now. There's a bit of a disconnect there between this part and the underneath. So I'm just going to join it together by a little passage and then scumble it away. Then I want a harder edge on this fin, just to really accentuate this fin and this fin which is behind the dolphin. And again I'm going to key that in and define snout a bit more. If it goes in any strange direction, you can just moisten it with a brush and correct that. This hard edge, I'll just soften that into the fin as well and taper it away. Then I want this one much darker, so the same colour going on, and this fin will really push the dolphin forward in the picture because it's much darker. I'm leaving that highlight there. It's much darker than the cloud behind, obviously, so it'll give us a nice contrast. And I'm going to very, very finely key this in to his back by a very fine line. And again, taper that away to nothing. And then have some more, a few sort of triangular shape on the base of the tail there for a bit of structure. And darker on this bridge above his nose, it's darker there. And make his snout a bit more rounded. Soften that off. I'm going to lift out a highlight there with a thirsty brush because that fin was overall a totally dark triangle and I want it to be a bit variegated. So press the brush in and roll some of that strong colour off. It's like an eraser. And now we're ready for the eyes. We'll just put a bit of darker blue for the eye there. If it runs too far as it's doing now, just press around it with a thirsty brush or use a bit of tissue. And then I'm going to use a very, very viscous speck of burnt sienna and French ultramarine blue, practically straight from the tube, so it's not too runny at all. and put a darker centre to that eye, and maybe a bit of a surround, more of a surround. The eye isn't very detailed because it's so distant. I'm just defining the mouth a little bit more there, and that ridge between the top of the eye, and a little bit of definition on that. I think we're ready to stop. So there he is, if I just zoom out. Okay, hope you've enjoyed this demo.